Hello and welcome back to another lecture. In this lecture, we will discuss about generic classes and methods. So it's a key concept in Java. So let us discuss about it. We'll start with generic classes. So generic classes are certain classes in which we can refer to any type of parameter. So generic classes use a type T parameter so that we can able to infer any types. So that is the goal of the generic classes. So we can write a particular generic code for all the classes which we want to write. So we will see in the practical how these generic classes we will implement. Now let us see the different types of type parameter list which is available for generic classes. So the first one is the T type and E element, K key, N number and V value. So that are the different type parameter list values which are provided. So for each one there is a specific meaning. We will see in the programs. Now let us see generic methods. So generic methods are certain methods in which we will use the type parameter the parameters to implement the generic concept. And generic methods are you can be static or non-static. Any type of methods can be generic. And one more thing is the scope of the particular argument is within the method scope. So whatever the method is there in that method body scope, the particular type parameter will be valid. So let us see some programs based on generic classes and methods to understand more. Thank you for watching. Now let us see the programs. Now let us see a simple program based on generic programming, generic classes. So in this program, I am going to create a simple data structure, generic data structure, which can hold any type of values and we can retrieve the values from the particular data structure. So let us start this program. So here I have a generic class. So here you can see how we will declare a generic class, generic followed by the type parameter in the angle brackets. And after that, I am having a two methods in the particular class. Each method will infer the type, and you can see the type, it is accessing the type. And the add item will add a particular type into the particular class, and it is an instance is there to store the particular object, T object. And after that, I am having a get method to get the particular item, and you can see the return type is T. So we can provide the return type as T in the generic method, generic class. So let us see the main method to see how this generic class will work. So here is the main method of the program. Here you can see I am creating a generic integer type generic class of that particular generic class. And I am adding it integer value, and I am getting the particular integer value. Similarly, I am doing it for string. I am creating a string value and adding the string value, and then I am printing the string value. So generic, if you didn't define a generic class, it can take any type of parameter, even if it is integer or string or anything. So we have to write the code like that in the generic class so that you can see the generic class. You can see in the generic class we can have the type T as a parameter, and then we can write the code according to the type T, and then we can write the accessing code and print adding code into the particular generic class. Now let us see the output of this program. Thank you. So here you can see the output has came. Both integer value and string values are getting printed. So it is able to get the particular integer value from the generic class. So this is our generic class. We can create our own custom generic class. In this class, we are seeing about this implementation of generic class. Now let us see another program about generic methods. Now let us see a program based on generic methods in Java. So in this program, we are going to create a generic method which will be used to print all the different types of arrays in Java. So let us start this program. So here you can see I have declared a generic method. So this is the syntax, e followed by the particular display array method name, and in that I am taking the elements, which means arrays will be passed as elements. So I am taking in the e of e square brackets, so to get the particular array elements. And after that I am using the enhanced for loop to go through each elements in the array and print each values. So it will automatically print the particular values present in the particular element. And this is how we will declare a generic method which will print the, all the values in the particular array. Now let us see the main method to see how I am accessing the particular generic member. And here you can see I have created two types, byte array and double array. And after that I am calling them same method with a different set of arrays. For double array and byte array I am calling the same method. So here you can see automatically the type will be inferred, and then based on the type it will be executing the loop. So let us see the output of this program. So here you can see the double array and byte array, both the values are getting printed. So that is it for output of this program. In this lecture we are covered about generic classes and generic methods. So they are used to implement the generic concept in Java, and it can have any type. So other types such as value, key, all the things you can discover by yourself. There are many generic classes which are available in the JDK itself, and we can explore one by one, and it will take a lot of time, but still you need to understand the concept of generics. And it is a very key concept which allow type safety feature in Java. And thank you for watching this lecture. I will be back with the next lecture. Thank you.